Hello everyone, Star here, and I have got a different kind of video for you here very clearly from what you're seeing on screen. We've got some drawing going on that is done by me, and I am going to be starting up kind of a new video series, I suppose you could call it, where if you've been a fan of my ramble videos, which I've made in the past, that's what these are going to be more like, where I talk about random stuff, stories, cool junk, whatever it happens to be, but rather than being put to gameplay, it's going to be put to things that I've drawn in the future. I'd like to, you know, maybe get some fan art on here to keep it relevant to games and all that stuff. Fan art's also fun to do. For this drawing, it was just a fun sketch that I decided to do one day of a scenic picture, sort of jibber-jabber. Got a couple of my personal characters in the background. I am not happy with how this video came out. In the future, they will be better, but the program I used to record this kind of really messed up a lot of the video recording, so there's going to be a lot of skipping around later where you're going to completely miss some things, so that's unfortunate. Next time it'll be better. Maybe get some Muzak in the background or something to help us chillax and talk about whatever it happens to be. Also not going to talk about the art this time. If you have any questions, because I know there are going to be some, like, what program is this, blah 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 blah, whatever. We'll talk about art stuff next time and get all that out of the way. So if you have any questions now, get to them. I won't answer them immediately, but I'll get to it eventually in the next video like this. Basically, you know, this is really just a means to talk about other stuff than Team Fortress 2. Sometimes it feels inappropriate to be talking about things when there's, like, you know, people getting blown up in the background. It's like, oh, this is a serious tone, but also watch this heavy get hit in the face with a frying pan. I don't know, but also, any people who enjoy watching this drawing stuff, that'd be really cool, because I've been really lazy with artwork lately, where I've kind of not been doing it as much as I used to, which is unfortunate, because it's fun, and a bit more productive than killing heavies in the face with frying pans, so that'll probably help me out, just getting this out there. But, real talk. That's what this is about, the commentary, which you can expect from these type of videos, and for this one, I'm going to tell a story, which ironically explains the fact that I really like hearing stories, and why, and it kind of ties in really weird, but. So, anyway, story time. Actually a story, as I think I said, about why I like stories, and I hope you guys do too. So, I live in New Jersey. And occasionally I go down to Boston to see my girlfriend, because she lives near Boston. And that is a 5-hour train ride that is ridiculous. It's 5 hours on a train by yourself. I'm not too good at passing time in those kind of situations anyway, but we'll get to that in a little bit. 5 hours to get there, I go see her, and then my brother lives kinda close by, so I went to go see him afterwards for a day or two. And then I had to leave to come back here to Jersey, and it was on a Monday, so my brother had to work in the morning, so there was kind of, my train, first of all, was at around 3 p.m. in the afternoon, so I could not get a ride to the train station around 3 p.m. in the afternoon, so what we kind of did was, he woke up, and on his way to work, he took me there, which was around 8 in the morning. He took me to the local train station. I was kind of worried that I was going to get lost, but then I had to go take a local train down to a subway, to the subway, to the train station I needed to get to, so I was kind of worried I was going to get lost, but, so I finally get there, skipping all that really irrelevant stuff. I finally get to the train station, and it was like 9 o'clock, and I have to wait till, I think, like 3 o'clock to wait for my train. I don't remember the exact times, but I do remember it was 6 hours total that I had to sit around and wait. And once again, I am not good at passing that kind of time. I don't know about you guys with your iPhones and your Nintendo DSs and your PSPs and your doodads and your gizmos. I don't have any of that. At most, I have an MP3 player, which I listen to almost the entire time, because music is pretty cool. And then, that's all I've got in my bag of tricks of things that I like to pass that kind of time with. Didn't really do anything else other than eat. There was a lot of good food places within the train station to eat at. So I went to McDonald's, raged a little bit, because why does McDonald's not serve hamburgers for breakfast? I mean, there's a couple of hours there, you're like, oh, McDonald's, I'm gonna get a cheeseburger. And then they just kinda, they don't. let you do that. I'm disappointing you. Other things, I sat there, I tried to draw for a while, but I couldn't really focus. I tried to sleep, because sleeping passes time very well, could not do that either. And I had a book in my suitcase, so I decided to read, which is something I do not normally do. It was The Watchtower, Gunslinger, Majigger by Mr. Stephen King, so I read that just to pass the time. And 4 or 5 hours through my wait. Remember, there's a 6-hour total, so I've been sitting in this train station, eating McDonald's, and reading a book for about 5 hours. And I guess someone kind of noticed that I had been there for 5 hours. So this old lady, she walks up to me, and, which is already weird. I don't go out nearly enough to think it's normal that some old lady comes up to talk to me. I don't know, so I'm kind of wondering, you know, what's going on? And then it was even weirder because to start off the conversation, she doesn't say, like, hey, how's it going? My name is Bessie Biggums. I'm here to tell you about law enforcement. I have no idea. It wasn't that kind of introduction. It was just she walks up to me and she says, are your parents divorced? Okay, and I kind of had this brief thought in my head that, if I answer yes, my parents are divorced, which is true, then she was going to say, well, the conversation was going to keep going, because it kind of seems like that leads into other things, and that's kind of the whole point of her coming up. If you say, oh no, my parents aren't divorced, we're very happy together, and it's a very nice family life, then she's going to say, oh, that's cool, great for you, and she's going to walk away and ask somebody else if their parents are divorced. I have no idea. But, I thought of saying no, that they weren't, just because it seemed like the easy get out of this conversation. But I say yes anyway, because I don't want to lie to a little old lady. And of course she has more to say after that, just like I expected. And she goes in, I don't say much, that's all I say, and she goes into this long story about her parents and how she grew up and how it was difficult because her parents were divorced too. And I really, really don't see where this conversation is going or why she's having it with me. She just, out of nowhere, this person is telling me all about, all about her childhood. Which is kind of tying into why I like stories that I didn't mind. At first it was kind of weird and awkward, and then it turned into story time, like my own personal story time. One, I'm trying to pass the time. I don't really care. Anyone could come up and talk to me about freaking potato chips. It would probably be nice. So she's telling me, like, all this, like, ridiculous personal stuff about her child and how it was very difficult for her, and blah, blah, blah. And that was cool. I enjoy hearing about that, because I think every person kind of has... There is no person who doesn't have an interesting story. Real talk stories are interesting, whether they're, like, exciting or not. Because usually the things you remember are the exciting things anyway, or interesting things at the very least. So her story was kind of interesting because it was real and you can kind of see what she was talking about, and I enjoyed that, which once again is the reasoning behind why I'm telling the story, is that I like hearing stories too. They're fun. Real stories are fun, even if they're about, oh, me and Johnny Boy back in the day used to go drink Sody Pop down at the deli. If they get a lot of detail into that, that story could probably become interesting at some point. And old people have much more interesting stories because they don't give a shit who they're telling about any of it. Kind of the same where if you're not that old, you could say, oh, I did this stupid thing when I was 5 years old. It was hilarious. I was in the hospital for 2 weeks. And, you know, all my friends hated me and we got into a fist fight. You won't tell somebody about that a week after it happens, so with so much detail, but, you know, when you grow up, you'll tell people about it, it's cool, and for old people, telling you stories about stuff that used to happen, most of the people, sadly enough, in the story are probably not around anymore, or they don't know them, so, I don't know, that's just my take on that, that they have, even the simplest boring stories are interesting. Anyway, back to the actual story of her telling me all this stuff. Because at this point, I still don't know why she's telling me this. I am completely confused. You come up to someone and ask them, are your parents divorced? And if they say yes, then you why? What is going on? The best I could think of was, like, maybe she's trying to, like, preach Christianity to me, or some other religion she came up with on her own, and how it helped her through these hard times, and I should buy a Bible off of her. I have no idea. So eventually the conversation gets to her telling me that rather than sitting in the train station like this, I should go find a shelter, and that would be much better for me, like it was for her, and it really helped her out through these hard times when she was homeless. And in my head, I have no idea what to say or think right now, because she's telling me this story because I've been sitting in a train station for 5 hours with a big suitcase, reading a book, and I didn't want to say anything, like, oh no, you got it all wrong, because she's already been telling the story for what seemed like 15 minutes at this point, and I don't want her to tell that whole story and be like, oh no, you got it all wrong, your story was a waste of time, you should probably get out of here, you're acting kind of weird at this point. Didn't want to say that. Also, I was enjoying the story, and she wasn't, like, expecting me to say much back, so she was just blah, 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 which was cool. So, I don't know, I just kind of sit there and listen, but it becomes really awkward because she's telling me about all of these homeless shelters I can go visit, and what it was like for her when she was a youngster, and how she had to... I have no idea. It was one of the most ridiculous moments of traveling. Actually, no, I take that back. I have had quite a few ridiculous experiences when traveling. Let me tell you this other story, because if that one wasn't interesting for you, I really only told it to, you know, bring home the point that I like hearing stories, hope you guys do too. And this one is a little bit more interesting, and it's just random dumb shit everyday life, but it's real. I used to go to New York a lot because my girlfriend, Mr. Sexy, once again, went to college in New York, and New York is an awesome place to begin with, so I went to New York a lot, used the subways a lot. One time I was going somewhere, I don't even remember where, but I got lost, I got on the wrong subway, I went to completely the wrong spot, so I'm sitting around waiting for a train, and I'm not sure exactly which one I'm waiting for, and this old guy walks up to me. Once again, old people are amazing, they don't give a shit what they say, they just, I have no idea. So this old guy walks up to me, he's kind of creepy looking, very, very creepy looking, kind of, I don't know, he looked like he had scrambled eggs all over his face, like around his lips, which was probably herpes. I don't know what herpes looks like, but it was something pretty nasty. I will get herpes and tell you what it looks like, or get a friend with herpes and figure that out for you. I'm sorry for my my lack of knowledge on the subject. So, I forget how, like, what the first thing he even said when he came up to me, because this one was actually quite a while ago, and I don't know, it was just like such a bizarre, like, Twilight Zone experience. This guy comes up to me with a bag, looks like he just came out from shopping, just one bag with, like, food in it, and he takes out his porn magazines and shows me. He's like, hey, you like these girls? What do you say at that point? I don't even know what to tell you guys. Like, I just stare at him like, once again, this is a situation where you can kind of tell what yes and no are going to mean. If you say no, I don't know what's gonna happen if I say no. I don't really like girls. Those aren't really, that's not interesting to me, I'm sorry. I don't know how that's gonna go. So I just say, yeah, I'm nodding, like, yeah, okay, please, can this train please show up? And can he please not be on the same train as me? And he's like, oh yeah, I love this. He's just looking at him, and he takes another thing out of his bag, and he's like, takes out Pringles, because he did have food in his bag. He's like, oh, you want a Pringle? I bet you'd really like some Pringles. I must admit, I really did want a Pringle. I really did want a Pringle, but I did not want a Pringle from this guy. I ain't taking any sort of crackers, canned goods, anything from the guy walking, the creepy, very creepy old guy, once again, coming up to me and showing me his porn magazines and, you know, sharing with me. So, I thought this was just going to be, I thought it was normal by now. I kind of calmed down. I was like, okay, this guy just really likes showing other people his pornography. I'll stand here and deal with it until the train comes. And then he was leaning in very closely because, like, I don't know if he didn't want anyone else to hear what we were talking about. but he leans in real close with his scrambled egg face and says, "You know, you got any money? I'll give you a hand job in the bathroom, you know, real quick." I cannot believe I'm even telling you guys this story. This is not content for YouTube, but bizarre traveling stories. There you go. This is once again. He says, "Do you want to go into the bathroom and we could do some creepy old guy stuff with scrambled eggs?" And once again, a situation where it's very clear in your head that there is a very distinct difference between saying yes and no. There are certain consequences for saying yes in this situation. They're a lot more clear than the other ones, but this time, no, I definitely didn't say yes. I stood there very awkwardly. I politely said, "No, thank you, sir. I'm not interested." Which was odd, because I actually was very calm about it. Like, "Oh, no, I'm not interested. I'm sorry. Sorry, this isn't working out for you. I don't want any of your Pringles either," because he kept freaking offering the Pringles. He did not stop. He's just Pringles in your face. So the train finally shows up. I jumped on it. I don't know if it was my train. Luckily, it was. But I jumped on it. He did not. I was quite happy for that. I got away from the Pringles guy, who I will never forget. And it is these simple, retarded stories that I absolutely love, and everybody has got one. I don't know, and the old lady I talked to in the train station telling me all about what it was like growing up homeless, she had clearly had tons of them, and I only got a small taste of that, but that's all I got for you guys today. I think I've got some other travel stories, maybe another time. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please let me know. It is definitely something different than what I've been posting. I hope you like this drawing. I will show you at the end of this video how messed up some of the video files were, because this is like creepy, once again, Twilight Zone sort of freaky stuff going on. I have no idea how that happened. I really need to find a different desktop capture program. If you have any recommendations, that's great. I used Cam Studio and it really, really messed up almost all of the files I had saved. So if you've been paying attention to the drawing, a lot of stuff was skipped. I'm sorry for that once again. I had more to say, but it's over. You can go see the full image over at my DeviantArt. The link will be in the description. And thank you all for listening.